took some time off to just kind of be me and figure out what Asia likes, what I don't like, what I really want to do, and try different things. I think a lot of times when you in sports, it's so hard because I've been to the Olympic Games. That's like the highest level you can go in your sports career. And so after that, when you think about changing or going to do something different, it's like, what's going to top the Olympics? It's like you can't figure out something that's really going to top the Olympics. And so you kind of get into this little depression because you feel like if you're not doing sports that way, then what are you going to do that's going to be fulfilling or make you happy or make others happy? And I just started to relearn myself. I tried different things. I attended a business program at Tuck, the business school at Dartmouth. I've done a fellowship program and work corporate. I've done mentorship programs with Ernst & Young and International Women's Forum just to kind of learn more business aspects and to immerse myself in the people I want to be around to continue to grow in different levels and different ways. And I think that you can't be scared to grow and change. And sometimes you're being led in a direction and you have to follow it and face it, no matter if other people are pushing you in another direction or you feel all this pressure you put on yourself. Sometimes you got to listen to that inner voice. So yeah, I'm on my way out. I don't know that I'll be pursuing 2022 Olympic Games, but I definitely think sports will always be a part of my life, and I will always have a passion for it and an involvement in it in some capacity.
Well, that is beautiful.
Thank you.
And the reason why I was asking that question was because we all want to know. We all want to know, obviously, that answer. But also to tie that into what's going on, what's coming up with All-Star, I didn't know if you were doing anything, if you were pursuing, if it changed, or what you would be in relation to the Olympics, if anything, with All-Star. And I guess in that case, you're not necessarily doing anything.
Well, not
directly.
Directly with All-Star. 2020 Olympic Games, the Summer Olympic Games are on the horizon. So they're really focused on Tokyo 2020, and I'm just excited. I mean, Tokyo 2020.
Yes.
I know one's Tokyo, one's Beijing. I keep getting confused. But yeah, Tokyo 2020 is going to be exciting. Mm-hmm. I would love to attend the Olympic Games as a spectator too, the Summer Olympics in particular. I've only been to the Winter Olympic Games, of course, and one of the best things about it for me was going to those other events and cheering people on.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, so it's dope. Like, I love to go to the Olympics just to kind of be a spectator and cheer on some people I may know and learn different sports. But as far as it pertains to All-Star Weekend, I have some activations and events I have going on out of the St. Jane Hotel, like I told you about, with Beauty and the Beast mode. And so I'm really excited about that.
So then for that one, is that open to the public? Can people buy tickets? Where do they go to find the information?
So for that, it's a leadership symposium. We'll have workshops ranging from leadership and performance, financial literacy, journalism, anything you can think of. We'll have some good workshops on that, as well as a networking lunch. So the student athletes and the guests will be able to network with a lot of the influential women I have in the building. Karen Sybil's one of them.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, that's my girl. So I'm excited to just kind of use my network and my platform to help inspire other women and other girls, and to, while they have the chance to use those tools. I think that's what it's about. Not discourage them in the sense that, like, you can't make it to the Olympics, so go try and learn a new skill, or go try this job because the chances are slim for you to pursue the Olympics or to make it to this championships or make it pro. My whole point in even this panel discussion I have going during Beauty and the Beast mode is it's going to be all Olympians, all medalists, all women that have excelled in their sports, but also we have to think about the future. We have to learn how to use our platform to build for life after sport, and to maximize it while we have that platform. And I think that's what the goal is with Beauty and the Beast mode, is to help these women understand how to apply the tools they have now to what they're doing and prepare for the future, as well as maximize their experience in their journey right now. So yeah.
Well, I will definitely share the information. So you all, I will be sharing the information that she's talking about. And I mean, I would love to attend. So I will check my calendar and everything, because I love what you do. She's amazing. So anything else going on that may not be, again, even All-Star related, because I know you are training.
Yeah.
So are there, people come to any, books
all
that spend that, like during that week
sure.
that are coming
so
out,
during
maybe
that week
want to work out?
You can always come work out with me. I am an instructor at Go Climb and Cryo, 300 West Ontario. It's a dope VersaClimber studio.
And I did it.
Yes, she came through and did it. Like 30-minute total body workout. You're on a VersaClimber machine, which I'm not sure if a lot of people are familiar with. So you're kind of climbing back and forth. You're feeling it everywhere, your arms, lower body, legs. But like, it's a great cardio workout with a good strength element to it. We black out the rooms, get a good music, and lights going, and it's 30 minutes, so you're in and out within that short amount of time and definitely killing it. And then we have a cryotherapy and recovery services after that too, so you can do whole body cryo, localized. Did you try cryo?
I didn't. I didn't have time to do it. No. Oh. I wasn't scared of it. I did not have time to do it.
Yeah.
And then I was just really, like, I was all over in that sushi, that plate.
Wow.
I was tearing that sushi up. Yes. So that was another reason why I didn't have time to do that, because I was eating. So
right
after my workout,
bad. So you're gonna have to check it out. During All-Star weekend, I have a women's appreciation workout going off that Friday afternoon, that I would love to have you at.
Okay.
And it's gonna be in partnership with Karen Civil. Awesome. And Ethica. They're gonna be sponsoring the clothing, so it's gonna be a really good vibe. Yeah, we'll have live DJ music.
Nice.
Yeah, so it's gonna be dope.
Okay. Well, I want to switch gears a little bit, because I'm looking at my GPS and ETA, and we're almost at your stop.
Okay.
So I know time is of essence. She's booked and busy and beautiful.
Hey. Yes, with the bees. Look busy and beautiful.
Yes. So we're going to do some rapid fire,
okay. And
this is all-star rapid fire questions. Okay. So I want the first thing that comes to mind, and we're just going to go through these quick.
Let's do it.
Okay. You're not nervous, are you?
A little bit, but...
Are your palms sweaty?
No, I'm good.
They're not? Okay.
Good,
all right. Well, all right. So, here we go. Harold's Chicken or Uncle Remus?
Ooh, Harold's.
What location?
Wow.
Because you know... Wait. Hold up. Because
you know, they don't know, right?
They may not know if they're coming from out of town. They may just
pop.
You know that matters, because they may pop up at a Harold's and then they're gonna be blaming you. They're gonna be all up in your comment section. They're gonna be tweeting you out, and they're gonna be talking trash and bullying you on social media because you sent them.
But if I have to be real, my favorite location is not exactly down in the city.
And that's fine.
Yeah, my favorite location is right off 167th.
Okay.
Country Club, and I love their food there. But I think what's a good location we can send them to in the city?
Oh man, don't put me in this. This isn't me. This is about you. No. No. We're going with yours.
Okay. Well, definitely.
I feel like
the locations do matter, but like the one I go to the most is in the burbs. But like, yeah.
That's fine. So best pizza in Chicago, period, is...
You got me. Okay.
People want to know. They're going to want to know these things.
Okay. I feel like it's a two-part answer to that, because I kind of put the original Uno's on a pedestal, like the actual original Uno's, like deep dish pizza. It's like the crust. I just can't get enough of that.
Okay.
But then you have Giordano's. You got Lou Malinotti. You got a lot of options. Mm-hmm. So it's hard to just say. I think for me personally, with deep dish, the original Uno's downtown, like down there by Water
Tower. Rush and something.
Yeah,
Wabash or something.
Exactly.
By Nordstrom.
It's one of my favorites.
Okay.
For the original deep dish. However, you can't go wrong with like some of the other ones.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So,
and if you want like thin crust too, I'm just gonna say Italian Fiesta will always be fire with the thin crust.
Right here. And you know what? Someone else said that. Someone else that was sitting in that very same chair picked that exact same pizza.
That thin crust
pizzeria.
Pizza, yeah.
Yes. 47th off 47.
Exactly.
So there you guys go.
Yeah.
Oh, we're not done yet.
Okay.
So for all the out of towners, would you recommend Uber, Lyft, or they should rent a car and use the Spot Hero app for parking? Which one would you think would be the most economical?
None of them are paying me, so I do not have...
And we on to the next one. And we're on to the next question. All right. Well, I don't know. This next question may be the same answer.
Just be safe.
Okay. So the next question may be the same answer. So if they're flying, Spirit, Southwest, one or the other?
Ooh. I would suggest flying into Midway. A lot of times that ends up being
Southwest.
She's
so... She's, what do you call it? Media savvy is this one. So we're going to skip that one.
Fly in the Midway. You're closest to the city, and it won't be a lot of travel and hassle to get to wherever your destination is. O'Hare is a little further out, so I would stick to one of the airlines that fly into Midway.
This one right here. You gotta love her. She's not giving y'all nothing. Nathan. Okay, so if you could, and we need an answer on this one.
Okay.
You ain't getting out of this one.
Okay.
If you had to, back against the wall, you have to spend the whole All-Star week and weekend with one celebrity and one celebrity only, like y'all kicking it, going everywhere together, who would you want and why? One celebrity. And you have to answer this one. You're not getting out of this one.
Ooh, that's a good question. Wait, so give me some, is it any celebrity?
Anyone.
Anyone
that... You know you have a favorite celebrity that you would want to kick it with. Who's your favorite?
I mean, my ultimate favorite, it's different. So, look, I have a favorite athlete.
Okay, then let's pick athlete to help you narrow it down.
My favorite athlete.
And you're going to hang out with them for the whole weekend. And they may see this, and it may really happen. Dreams come true. So, who is it?
Dang, I gotta...
Rapid fire. You gotta pick.
Oh, I know. I gotta... Okay. So, favorite celebrity to hang out with during All-Star Weekend?
If you could. And it doesn't have to be someone, because we know you really do hang out with celebrities. So, it doesn't have to be, like, your real friend. Like, it could be someone that you have no access to.
Yeah. So, I'm a big, big fan of Serena Williams. Like, I love her and definitely still want to meet her to this day.
Okay.
She's one of my top favorite athletes.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that fun celebrity-wise, who would I want to
meet? Oh, so she's not the answer?
I mean, no, she is. But, like, I'm thinking more like an artist or like someone on the entertainment side that might be fun.
Who is that person?
We just gonna leave it at Serena, because I feel like anything else might get me in trouble.
Okay, so we'll say Serena. Serena's great. We will say Serena.
I love Serena.
I would love to see you all hanging out, and then you know let me know where y'all at, so I can come through and just pull up and just, you know, give you guys your accolades, give you guys your flowers, because we're at her destination. I pulled over, we're actually here. And so I want to say in closing that, again, the impact that you have had on Black women, Black girls, and not just Black, but just people in general. Like, we have to give each other our flowers while we're alive to smell them and appreciate them. And I hope, God willing, you have gotten that and you continue to get it, because like I said, you are a breath of fresh air.
Thank you.
So beautiful. You are so amazing. And thank you for allowing me to even drive you and your precious, because you are precious hardware. You are metal in yourself. Thank you for allowing me to have you in my Jeep. So for She's Gotta Show, you all know me. I'm Akeisha Lockhart. But remind them who you are again.
Again, I'm Asia Evans, your favorite Chicago Olympian, 2-time Olympic bronze medalist, and excited to be here with my girl Keisha, and I can't thank her enough for having me. Bye.
That was perfect.
Thank you.
You're welcome.